IHTM Sports.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, tonight's men's basketball game between the Indian Hill Braves and the Finneytown Wildcats. Today's senior night here at Indian Hill, and the Braves starting five seniors. Now, that's just five of the 11 on the team, but Shep Ward getting the start tonight, and with C.J. Hayden, and Eli Riggs, and Noah Frazier, and of course John Pottigel. So if the Braves could have could start 11, I'm sure Coach Hill would, but he's got five of his top seniors starting today. Colton Smith will, I'm sure, be in the bench, off the bench very shortly, as will Charlie Isherding and Zach Jones. But here we go. It's the Braves and the Finneytown Wildcats. C.J. Hayden tips it over there to Pottigel, and we're off. Noah Frazier into C.J. Hayden with a turnaround. 2-0. Here comes the press. There's the trap. They get it out. Yeah. That's Woods, number five. Harmon, number 11. Bryce Bryant. Ellamore with a miss, and the Finneytown will keep maintain possession. Dykes, Alex Dykes. And he's out in Finneytown. Deep one by Woods. That's out. And the smallest guy on the floor, Noah Frazier, grabs the rebound, and he's fouled quickly.
Noah Frazier, what a way to fight for the ball right there. Immediately going for the rebound right there. Yeah, despite being the shortest person on the court right now, definitely not possibly the most energetic on the court right now.
And with the most colorful shoes.
Oh, yeah. Actually, maybe.
Pottigel, it misses, and Finneytown get the rebound there. It's Woods, and he brings it up himself. Dykes. Shep Ward doing a great job defensively, as always. That was number three, Bryant, and again, Noah Frazier leading the team in rebounding, at least in this game. C.J. Hayden back out to Pottigel, tops it off to Eli Riggs, and he's fouled.
Definitely good ball movement there by Finneytown. I mean, while the Braves are getting fast, quick scores right now, Finneytown is definitely moving the ball around pretty well, which is definitely good to see. If they want to minimize the scoring, they want to keep the ball as long as they can.
Eli misses the first. Eli Riggs is hitting 63.2% of his field goal attempts this year. Just tremendous.
One of the highest in the CHL, actually.
And he makes the second with a soft touch. Finneytown gets it in quickly and beats the press. Eli Riggs forces it, and it's a turnover there. Noah Frazier intercepts it.
His third one already.
Hayden back out to Pottigel with a three, and it's in. John Pottigel. Braves race out to a 6-0 lead. Here comes the press. And it's intercepted by Eli Riggs. Out to Shep Ward, and uh-oh, Pottigel's hurt. John Pottigel hurt his right or his left wrist. I believe it's his left wrist. He's shaking it, and or maybe he dislocated his thumb. He's kind of playing with the thumb, and he's not coming out. And, man.
Quite a fight.
He just hurt his thumb. He's probably not going to shoot, but just hit a nice three. Here's Shep Ward. CJ, over to Shep. Noah Frazier. And there's CJ Hayden. A lefty hook, it's off. Gets a rebound. Oh, Eli Riggs, Shep Ward. And it's off. Man, three for a dollar, guys. CJ hits the floor.
So let me get this straight. I think that was Eli Riggs, CJ Hayden, Shep Ward.
Everybody gets a chance. And oh, Potajo with a beautiful drive. He's fouled. And Dykes with his first foul. That's the third foul on Finneytown. We've played just under 3 minutes. And John, bad thumb and all, makes the first. And here comes Colton Smith for Eli Riggs.
I think Zachary Jones will be coming in for...
For Potajel if he makes the shot.
Yeah, definitely.
And he does.
Sinks it.
John Potajel with five early points for the Braves, and the Braves up 8-0.
He recently committed to Miami, Ohio for track and field.
Oh, great. Oh, that's terrific.
Yeah.
Love and honor. Here's Dykes. There's Bryant, and it's off. And Noah Frazier again, his third rebound of the first quarter. Oh, there's Noah Frazier. I think they want him on the block, as big as he's playing. Colton Smith looks inside to Hayden, and it's knocked away. There's Woods, and they're going to call a foul on the Braves. And it's on Shep Ward. Braves staying in their man-to-man. There's Dykes. It's off. Colton Smith snares it away. Shep Ward looking. There's Zach Jones. Big. Colton Smith can't find the rim, and they're going to call it. Call a foul on offensive foul here on Woods. So Finneytown with their fourth foul.
Charlie Isferding comes in for Noah Frazier. Noah has had an amazing game right now.
It's all seniors all the time.
Oh, yeah. Zach Jones up for three.
Oh. Zach Jones. 11-0. Steal by Colton Smith. Gives it up to CJ. And now it's 13-0 and a timeout. Coach Reggie Woods of Finneytown with a timeout. The Braves up 13-0. Only playing seniors.
Definitely good showing from Indian Hill. Definitely showing the press is definitely working for him tonight already. A bunch of steals, especially from Noah Frazier right there. Definitely good job by the Braves right there. But we have seen when Finneytown can get the ball past half court, they can move it for a pretty large amount of time.
Yep. They Finneytown struggles. We mentioned they've they're 2-8 in the league this year, which they're tied for sixth. 6-10 overall. Now they started the year 6-5 overall. They've lost their last five games. But they don't have a very deep rotation. And he just throws it away. The Finneytown guys are arguing with each other. That's a turnover on Marvin Siakam.
Jalen Woods seems to be limping a little bit.
Yeah.
Let's hope he's okay.
Eli Riggs comes back in, and C.J. Hayden goes out. So maybe it's going to be all seniors up. Wide up, Charlie Ishverding drives, gives it up. Riggs, and there's Zach Jones. And Finneytown picks it up, 13-0 Braves. A little over 3 minutes left here in the first quarter. Up. Well, if Noah Frazier was in the game, that would have been a steal. Elmore. Woods. He goes in, and that should be a jump ball, and it is. Shep Ward doing a nice job.
Not
Colton
drunk.
Smith getting a sandwich there.
Definitely a good way not to draw the foul by causing the jump ball right there.
And got another senior coming in for the Braves, Jalen Williams, coming in for Shep Ward. So Jalen Williams getting some first quarter action.
Great to see that from him. One of the fastest on the team.
Oh, nice juggling app by Dykes. And the Braves, Jalen Williams will not give up on that. There's another jump ball.
That will go right to the Braves.
Nice job, Jalen Williams. Hit the floor. So the Braves with five seniors still on the floor have not played an underclassman yet. Zach Jones, Colton Smith, Charlie Ishverding, Eli Riggs, and Jalen Williams are the five on the court right now for the Braves. And Dev Missali goes to the scores table. Zach Jones with a miss.
Who do you think the first underclassman will be?
Jalen Williams knocks it loose, but the Braves can't go. There goes Dykes. Nice rebound. That's Woods. No, I'm sorry. It was Sycam with that rebound.
Dev Mosali will now come in for Eli Riggs
for
right
Eli
there.
Riggs, yeah.
Great to see him in right here, right now.
This may be the smallest lineup the Braves have employed all year. The Colton Smith at center, and I guess Charlie Ishverding is at the four spot now.
They're definitely mighty. Not the tallest, but definitely mighty.
Well, certainly athletic with Charlie Ishverding in there.
Well, all the seniors right now that are able to play are playing, right? Have played already tonight.
Zach Jones with a steal. Oh, my goodness.
He is fouled.
Jack Zones driving in hard, and he's fouled by Sycam. Oh, I'm sorry. They called it on Bryce Bryant, number three for Finneytown, and Zach Jones shooting two. Braves in the penalty situation already. Five. That was the fifth foul on Finneytown, and as we've mentioned every game this year, because it is new, that there's no more one and one in high school basketball. It's in and again, out again for Zach Jones. The Braves up 14-0. The fifth foul of each quarter becomes a two-shot foul.
The infamous Bull will say no on that one.
Dykes. Charlie Ishverding with the tie-up. And they're going to call a foul? Wow.
I thought that was a jump ball. That looked like.
I think one ref called that, and another one decided that the score 14-0. He's not going to. He's going to ref the score. So Charlie Ishverding giving credit for a foul. There's Dykes.
Good pump fake right there.
And that goes over the backboard, and the Braves will inbound it up 14-0 here with a minute 13 left until the end of the quarter, and Zach Jones brings it up. Got Jalen Williams and Dev Missali. Charlie Ishverding and Colton Smith. Colton Smith passed it out to Ishverding, Jalen Williams, Zach Jones. Nice pass. Colton Smith gets his own rebound. And Zach, now we're down to 42 seconds. Colton Smith gives it to Miss Alley.
Oh!
Jalen Williams with the rebound. And he fires it up. It's off. Charlie Ishverding saves it to Miss Alley. Colton Smith, Zach Jones, and the Braves maybe will hold it back out now for one shot. Maybe not.
Happy to know I helped announce that that three-pointer he had. Now, will Zachary Jones make the decision shoot a cool buzzer beater?
Jalen Williams will.
Oh!
It's off. Charlie Ishverding. And it's off. Yeah. So the Braves, the end of the first quarter comes to a conclusion. The Braves up 14-0. I do that for Charlie Ishverding, the soccer player. Well, I mentioned Coach Reggie Hall, the Finneytown coach, just his second year here at Finneytown. He was the head coach at Bethel Tate for several years prior to coming here. And the last winning season at Finneytown was the 2012-2013 season when the coach was Adam Griggs, an Indian Hill graduate, and his family, including his younger brother John Griggs, was a tremendous point guard here. Adam Griggs did a great job there at Finneytown, and they've struggled since. Coach Taylor trying to bring him back has done a nice job. They just don't have the numbers really right now. He only tends to rotate seven or eight players, and when you're pressing like Indian Hill does, it takes a lot out of you. You get somebody hurt, get somebody in foul trouble, and that can cause you a lot of heartburn.
It can cause definitely a large amount of stamina and toughness for the Finneytown players right here.
Well, we go with five seniors again. Up, Dykes, and they're going to call a foul on, is that on Eli Riggs?
Maybe on Hayden or Potichel, maybe. I don't know.
They do call it on Eli. It's his first. The Braves with C.J. Hayden, Eli Riggs inside. Dykes misses the first one. Noah Frazier, the big rebounder. John Potigel, hopefully it looks like his hand got bandaged, and Zach Jones. So the Braves with their five, and Finneytown dents the scoreboard with 7:52 left until the second quarter. Zach Jones with a floater, it's off. Eli Riggs, it's off. And Finneytown will retain possession. Dykes tries to pass it up there. C.J. Hayden with a block. Wow.
That looked like old ball to me. Well, definitely facing away from us. I didn't see any.
C.J. thought so, too. He went straight up. Yeah, I think elbows to your ears, and that certainly looked like he did a textbook. But first one misses. This is Bryce Bryant, the leading scorer here for Finneytown, averaging 9.3 points a game. He misses a second, and who gets the rebound? Noah Frazier. Again, we've got him counted as four rebounds. Well, Zach Jones gets it.
He is representing.
Out of jail, up to Frazier, wide open.
He's representing us smaller guys very well tonight.
Zach Jones with a miss, but he gets his own rebound, a floater, and it misses. C.J. Hayden, and he's crushed. And they call a foul there.
Definitely a good rebound game for the Braves tonight. Even though the layups aren't always falling in, there's always been at least one guy to pick up that rebound. C.J. Hayden come off of a big injury there. Nice to see him back, at least for the basketball season. Recently committed to Iowa State.
For football?
Yes.
C.J. Hayden takes his, C.J. hurt that, he had a major surgery on his right knee. Back in May. Eli Riggs with the rebound. Zachary Jones with a three. And the Braves go up 17-1. Eli Riggs with another steal. Passes it out to Zach Jones. Noah Frazier into C.J. Hayden, and that's in. The Braves get it going. All seniors all the time. Oh, Riggs goes for the steal. He misses it, and it's a wide-open opportunity there for Elmore for Finneytown. Shep Ward and, the first non-senior of the night coming in. It looks like Devlin Daniel, a freshman. Potigel into Eli Riggs.
Oh, and here comes William Bennett.
Oh, okay.
You really just had jinxing, huh? And along him comes Charlie Isverding. Got a whole new five.
Yeah.
That's a whole new clean batch of guys.
Eli Riggs, you've traveled. That was too easy. Eli's used to getting banged around and was embracing the contact when there was none.
Sometimes he brings a contact, especially in football this year. Well, out comes...
As you mentioned, with the Braves with a whole new starting five and only three seniors, which is unusual for the Braves tonight. It's the first time. Colton Smith, Charlie Isherding, and Shep Ward, the three seniors. Devlin Daniel, the freshman. And William Bennett, who started most games this year, the sophomore, is in the lineup for the Braves right now. There's Dykes. Wide open shot there for Woods. And he misses. Isherding with the rebound. Devlin Daniel. Charlie. Shep Ward inside to Colton Smith. Trying to play high-low with William Bennett. And Shep Ward will set it up. Charlie Isherding into Colton Smith. And it's good. Nice pass by Charlie Isherding. There's Dykes. Woods. And it's in. So the second basket of the night
nothing
for Finneytown.
Nothing but net right there on that three.
Colton Smith gets it knocked away. And here's Woods. Over to Dykes.
Had a little spin right there on the catch.
And they're going to call a foul on Finneytown.
I think that was on number 21, Braylon Elmore.
Well, the Addicts are calling it on five on Woods, and that'll be Woods' third foul. So Mr. Woods will be sitting in the woods here probably until at least the third quarter. And Shep Ward will bring it up for the Braves.
I don't think I would have come up with that one.
Into William Bennett. He's fouled. No call, but it goes in. William Bennett. And there's a timeout. Was there a timeout?
We have some confusion on the court.
Maybe it's a bench warning. I don't know why they would have stopped the game, but maybe the referee heard something or... But it's not a timeout. Finneytown will inbound the ball. Braves up 23-5, almost halfway through the second quarter. Again, Woods out of the game with three fouls already. That is a bench warning.
Something you don't see every day. Yeah.
Dykes out there to Bryant, and it's Bryce
another,
Bryant.
Another good three by him right there. That's why he's tied for the leading scorer on the team here.
Well, Patrick, let's take a look at the first quarter stats and get your impression.
Well, obviously the Braves are winning the assist round with four. Both teams are tied with nine rebounds. The Finneytown Wildcats struggling with the shooting game. We definitely have eight turnovers over the two from Indian Hill. The Braves have a 27% field goal range, but well, definitely a very good shooting overall.
Eight turnovers in one quarter.
Eesh, that is.
That's
most of them committed on the other side of the court.
Well, and it gives the Braves a loose ball turnover, gives you a fast break, and that's where most of them were. So, but Finneytown gets two quick baskets here and closes the margin to just 15. It's 23-8.
Gives them a lot of breathing room.
And that was Finneytown that just called the timeout. I didn't see Coach Hill get off the bench, so I was kind of curious who was calling timeout. But it was,
Daniel
gets it tipped away. There's Sycam. Dykes. Bryant. Nope. Devlin Daniel. Oh, that's double dribble. Thank you. And Dykes has another turnover here for Finneytown. Be interesting to see if the Braves, when they put it in the basket the next time, if Coach Hill still has the full court press on. Charlie Isserding looking inside.
Wonder if they'll...
William Bennett inside. Shep Ward. And it's in. Nice job, Shep.
I wonder if they'll put in more underclassmen like Cam Miller and Ashton Graham, maybe.
Well, Coach Hill's kind of called off the dogs. No press.
Yep.
Sycam looked nice. Devlin Daniel and Shep Ward battling each other for the rebound. There's Devlin. And Shep Ward will bring it back out and look around. Ward inside to Devlin Daniel. It's blocked. But up there by Colton Smith. Gets the rebound and sticks it back. So Colton Smith with 4 points tonight. Braves go up 27-8 as we approach the two-minute mark here in the first half. I was hoping Noah Frazier would stay in and get a double-digit rebounds tonight.
Hopefully, especially on senior night. But I'm pretty confident he'll come back in a little bit at one point in the game.
Colton Smith there commits a foul. Colton's first. And Bryce Bryant.
Oh, we got a replay right here.
I think that'll be Colton Smith's.
It's Devlin Daniel.
Daniels gets blocked, and Colton Smith right in the right place and sticks it back in.
Definitely a great rebound by Colton Smith. And we have another new five coming in. Yeah. Eli Riggs, Zachary Jones, C.J. Hayden, Noah Frazier,
well,
and...
that's the starting five.
Oh, yeah.
And coming in for maybe the last 2 minutes of the first half, but Noah Frazier in our unofficial count with 4 rebounds already. That's got to be his high for the season and probably his career.
On the perfect night to do that.
Zach Jones. And there's Noah. C.J. Hayden looking inside. Doesn't find anybody, but, oh. Noah Frazier couldn't hold it. Had an open shot if he had fielded it cleanly. And there's Zach Jones. C.J. Hayden. Wide open. Noah Frazier head pumps. Lets it go, and it's in. Noah Frazier going for a double-double tonight. Sycam and Dykes. C.J. Hayden with an easy rebound there. Potigel. Zach Jones, and it's off. C.J. Hayden. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Eli Riggs gets the rebound.
Who eventually gets it to C.J. Hayden.
Yeah.
going all around the world.
Noah Frazier.
Oh.
Eli Riggs had a pretty easy basket there and gave it up to his teammate, which is, he is an awfully unselfish player.
Definitely selfless, good for any player.
And it looks like Finneytown, down 19, will hold for the last shot here. And another timeout. That's Finneytown's third timeout of the first half. So they only have two left here in the second half. Here's the play. Noah Frazier, pump fakes, and a little floater, and Noah Frazier with a deuce. Finneytown with only two timeouts left for the rest of the game.
I forgot this,
this may be a quick game. I don't think Ricardo Hill's going to use timeouts. Not that Coach Hill is going to bother himself with this, but with 15 seconds left and the Braves up 19, Finneytown with the ball, the Braves do have a foul to give.
Yeah, I wonder if you even try to get the ball back, maybe force foul, or maybe you just
don't. Well, you can afford to be aggressive, and if you steal the ball, lovely, and if you don't, then commit a foul, and Finneytown just has to reset. And if you commit the foul with under 5 seconds left, that's going to make it a little bit more difficult for Finneytown to get the ball where they want it. See Principal Jeff D'Amadeo down there cheerleading as usual. Does a phenomenal job with the this Indian Hill High School. Has been our leader here for a number of years and just done a great job. Incredibly enthusiastic and supportive of every kid that plays here.
Definitely a cooler principal, if I say so myself.
Dykes. Oh, it looked good, okay. And it is not. And the Braves will go to the locker room with a 29-10 lead. Coach Hill looks calm and relaxed for one of the few times this year. And talking to Principal D'Amadeo on the way, hopefully he didn't do anything wrong.
Well, I had him as my computer science teacher, so I definitely saw his chill, more relaxed side a lot more often. Definitely made him very likable.
Well, the Braves go to halftime with a 29-10 lead. Nobody in any foul trouble, and seniors leading the way. 2 points for William Bennett, the other 27 all by the Braves seniors as Coach Hill tries to get as many of them as much opportunity as he can. Patrick, we're going to take a break here for halftime, and hopefully our audience will come back and join us here the second half in about 10 minutes.
Hopefully.
Choose the Weiler way today. Tired of the traditional online car shopping experience? When you visit our Weiler websites and have a question, we have dealership professionals who will chat with you live. Rooted in family, driven by you.
Thank you. The Indian Hill Athletic Hall of Fame welcomes three new members with the class of 2024. Ted Bolzer was an All-Ohio receiver, played in Indiana, and was drafted by the Washington Redskins. Dan Murphy set the single-season scoring record at Indian Hill before playing point guard for the Cincinnati Bearcats. Coach Kevin Seipel won six league titles in a 10-year span and had over 100 players in the program. Make plans to join us at halftime on January 26th to welcome these new Indian Hill Hall of Famers.
All right, team. We got a long day ahead of us, but this is what we do. It's time to go to work. Yeah, let's get it.
We work, work, we get stuff done.
Right.
No matter what the problem, we just roll up our sleeves.
We do.
Not afraid of the project,
oh, no.
Not afraid of the time.
Okay.
Say it, I build America, we always on time.
Let's get
we
it.
Work,
we work,
we work,
we work,
we get stuff done.
We do.
No matter what the problem,
yeah.
We just roll up our sleeves.
That's right.
Not afraid of the project,
oh, no.
Not afraid of the time.
We got
say it, I build America, we always on time.
Let's do
listen,
it.
Do you know the mission?
Huh?
Story.
Do you?
We've been at it for a minute,
yeah.
So we're not here for the glory.
Oh, no.
We aggregate, crush rock, 24/7, non-stop. Our products high in calcium, low in that magnesium. We'll mix it up, then bag it.
Bag it.
Y'all know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Looking for a new home? You'll love SibseyKline.com. For the latest new listings, price changes, and open houses, make it part of your everyday routine.
When a new listing is posted, I want to be among the first to find it. My secret weapon? SibseyKline.com. I start each day with a cup of coffee, the latest new listings, price changes, and all the home buying tools I need.
That's just the beginning of what you'll find at SibseyKline.
Choose the Weiler way today. We value your time and convenience. Visit Weiler.com and shop over 7,000 cars. See estimated monthly payments. Value your trade and get pre-approved. Rooted in family. Driven by you.
Dude, zoom into the guy shooting, please. All right, I'm going to switch the camera, too. All right, camera two, you're live. Camera one, can you zoom back out to include the shot, please? Thank you. All right. And then I need you to get the graphics up, please, for free throw. I think it's, what is it, number 12? All right, graphics are going in. All right, switching to one. Good shot there, one. We're going to go back to two. I'm going to take the graphics out. Can we get the score bug back on, please? All right, bring those back in. All right, one back up. All right, two. I need you to be close on this one. All right, I need you to follow the point guard as he brings up the ball. All right, going back to two. One, I want you now to go down to the other end of the court. Just don't let you have a wide shot. We're going to switch to you once into the middle of the court. All right, switching to one. All right, good shot there, two. Now two, just stay close, all right? We want you to be close. We want you just to be like a close camera. All right, good shot there, one. That's good. Oh, and also camera two. I want you to try to keep the ball in the frame as much as you can. All right, that's not a bad shot. All right, two. I want you to zoom in on the guy throwing the ball in, please. All right, not too much. Zoom a little bit back out. All right, perfect. Announcers, I have a replay of that. All right, we're gonna roll a replay. Let's get DDR one up there. All right.
Gymnasium. Tony Harris here with Patrick Langworthy to bring you the second half action. Indian Hill clinging to a 29-10 lead here as we enter the third quarter on senior night. And the five seniors that started the game for the Braves, Captain John Pottigel, Shep Ward, Noah Frazier, C.J. Hayden, and Eli Riggs starting here for the third quarter for the Braves. Hayden looking inside for Riggs, not available, and bring it back out again. Pottigel, Noah Frazier, Riggs inside to Hayden, and he gets it. Nice high-low.
He's a master at that point.
And the number three, Bryant, leading scorer, tied for leading scorer with for Finneytown on the year. We have not seen Adrian Benton, number 12, who very, very, probably their most impressive player, but has not played. Nor has Jace Ridley, number 10. So Finneytown maybe a little shorthanded tonight. There's Dykes into Elmore. And they're going to call a foul. C.J. Hayden committing a second foul. Elmore goes to the line. Elmore's 2-for-6 on the year from the free throw line. There's 6 free throws on the entire season. There's only one guy on Finneytown who's taken more than 22 free throws all year, and this is game number 17.
Oh, he missed the second.
C.J. Hayden. And Shep Ward will lead the Braves up. So inside, Eli Riggs. Eli Riggs, just his second and third points of the evening. There's Dykes trying to bang in there. Shep Ward not giving any ground, but nice pass there to Bryant. And Bryce Bryant, leading scorer for Finneytown on the season, and he now has 7 of Finneytown's 12 points on the evening. Pottigel.
Oh!
Bring the noise there.
I know it's not NBA champ, but he's going to make me say, boom, shakalaka.
Well, there's seniors versus senior. Right with a miss.
Good save right there by
Sykamp.
Yeah.
Miss Shep Ward with a rebound. There's Eli Riggs.
Gets right to it.
Pottigel. Noah Frazier. Not a shooter tonight. He's a rebounder.
He's been pretty good.
Pottigel looking inside. Shep Ward.
Oh.
And it's good. Nice job. The quarterback taking care of business as usual.
I always love when he makes a quarterback like throw in a basketball game.
Eli Riggs with the steal. Slows it down. And Shep Ward will set it up. And here come Pottigel with a miss. C.J. Hayden. And it misses. And Bryant off with the rebound. Braves will be substituting 5 at the next stoppage of play.
Comes in a fresh new Mac.
They're calling a travel there on Bryant and the Braves. We're going to see the replay, I think, of C.J. Hayden, the alley-oop there from Pottigel to Hayden. Really a thing of beauty.
Boom!
Kind of like they planned it.
Yeah.
Charlie Isfording, Colton Smith. It's a Brave substitute 5. There's Zachary Jones, Devlin Daniel, and William Bennett's the 5th new guy. There's Colton Smith with a nice open jumper. Misses, gets his own rebound. Zachary Jones. And he sends it back, sets it back up. Isfording back to Zach. And it's off. William Bennett, they're going to call a push off on William. That'll be William's first foul of the evening.
Braves have done a very good job limiting their fouls the entire game.
And a very tired Alex Dykes walking it up the court here for Finneytown.
Really got to commend Finneytown. I know I said it earlier, but their stamina and their toughness getting through most of these games is truly unmatched.
Zach gets a little help as Colton Smith slides over to help, and here comes Dykes. And he will not shoot. Off-ball help there from Devlin Daniel. And Dykes, nice looking three. So Dykes with his second, third, and fourth points of the evening on that one. Ishreding, William Bennett into Colton Smith. Back to Ishreding. This is out to William Bennett, and makes a nice move, but they're going to call travel on William.
Checking in for Finneytown, 15, Marco Bryant.
So DeMarco Bryant, number 15, checks in for Finneytown.
Bryce Bryant with that another three. I think maybe his third of the night.
Again, Bryce Bryant has 10 of the 18 points for Finneytown this evening. The average is 9.3. Devlin Daniel gets the ball blocked, but he's fouled there by Bryant. That'll be Bryant's second foul of the evening. I mentioned before, Devlin Daniel, 5'11".
Devlin Daniel, shoot two.
Plays much, much bigger than that.
He looks much bigger than that as someone who's seen him in real life.
This is a second. Cy came with the rebound, and here comes Dykes. Forces a thought was a turnover there, not quite. Devlin Daniel sweeping the boards. Ishreding, and there comes Zach Jones to set it up with just under 2:20 left here at the end of the third quarter. William Bennett off the board, no good, and a foul on Devlin Daniel. Devlin's first foul of the evening. Finneytown tends to take a lot of threes. They don't have much size. Oh, Colton Smith.
Smith.
Colton Smith says to C.J. Hayden, whatever you can do, I can do too. And Colton flips for the flush.
You're not the only one who can dunk.
It's off. Charlie Ishreding, Devlin Daniel, and Braves coming down. Colton Smith wants that ball. He's asking for it. Charlie Ishreding, Devlin Daniel, Zach Jones. Braves reset. And it's off. Patrick, I gotta tell you, Charlie Ishreding passes up more open shots than anyone I've ever seen. He just wants to get assists, and he's a phenomenal athlete. We've all seen that on the soccer fields, but Charlie Ishreding has points that could go to his name, and he's just so unselfish.
Yeah, you love to see that.
Everybody else score.
You love to see that on any any athletic team. Oh.
Colton Smith calling for the ball down low and kicks off a Finneytown player with 50 seconds left. And the Braves up. Oh. Uh-oh. Bryant with him.
DeMarco Bryant.
DeMarco Bryant.
Definitely good fast.
Had only 16 points in the season coming into tonight, and there's a quick two. Zach Jones, nice play. Braves getting a little sloppy with the ball. Zach Jones rips it away. Into William Bennett, and the Braves will hold for one with 20 seconds left. Finneytown with fouls to give. Charlie Ishverding. Oh, and he lets it go off his hands. Shoot. 12 seconds left. Braves with only three fouls, so the Braves actually have a foul to give, if they're so inclined. Dykes. 5 seconds. Got a foul to give. Nice coming off his hands, but no good. And the Braves lead 40-20 here at the end of third quarter. I see that alley-oop again to C.J. Hayden. That was a thing of beauty.
Botticello comes in right here. She's right there on the quarterback throw. Boom!
Beautiful.
Definitely a football connection right there from Podgill to Hayden. Yep. Nice to see that basketball.
Well, unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to see him much of it this year because CJ was hurt, but CJ, a wonderful wide receiver for the Braves. Podgill, a magnificent quarterback. Both of them had injuries this year. CJ really didn't get a chance to play all year. And John got hurt and miraculously came back for the last several games and obviously led the Braves to the CHL championship.
Definitely good to see him come back in the middle of the season.
Yep.
Well, from our halftime stats, Indian Hill, of course, leading in assists and rebounds again, especially in the free throws and shooting. Indian Hill definitely got a little bit more turnovers, but Finneytown got the more with 10 compared to 6.
Halftime. Hopefully we get the third quarter stats coming up here soon. Wow.
Quite a three from Bryce Syke, from Marvin
Sykamp. Sykamp's fifth three of the year. He's only and there's a turnover for the Braves.
C.J. Hayden nearly came from behind.
That's off C.J. with the rebound. And all right, they're going to call the Braves. That was they could have called a foul on Bryant there, but they chose not to. Colton Smith, John Podigel, Zach Jones, Noah Frazier, and C.J. Hayden, the five into the Braves right now. They're looking inside. Noah passes up an open three. Podigel looking inside. There's CJ, and he gets it kicked away from him.
And
giving the ball to the Braves.
Go to Indian Hill. I know Alex Dykes was looking for the arrow to go to Finneytown.
CJ, he was bumped. Colton Smith.
Puts it
nice
for
job.
Two.
Colton Smith now with 9 points on the night. Now eight, I'm sorry. Braves with some balanced scoring. C.J. Hayden with 10. Colton Smith with 8. Zach Jones with 7. Leading the Braves.
You know, it's great to see...
wide open, Noah Frazier. Jones with, I don't know if that was an alley-oop or a pass. but Finneytown will get the ball.
You know, it's always fun to see the senior parents putting up big fat heads of their son's head. It's always kind of fun to see him like that, you know. They score, you know, they see a little movement, especially the student section as well.
Wow.
Great side cam. Frazier gets it, now gets it to Hayden. Open.
Zach Jones.
Three-pointer, Zach Jones.
He's been shooting pretty well at the three-point line tonight. 10 points.
You mentioned Marvin Sykam with 2 threes tonight in this quarter. And he only had 4 for the whole season coming in. So there's Potigel. And he finds Zach Jones.
Oh.
It's off. CJ with the rebound. Gives it up to Noah Frazier. It's off. Colton Smith with the rebound. Zach Jones. It's off. And Finneytown with a rebound. Braves missed 3 threes on that possession.
Not the best.
Dykes. Bryant. We get to the 5-minute mark. Braves up 19, and here comes Shep Ward for the Braves on the next stop of the play. Sykam. Bryant. It's off. Noah Frazier, rebound number 5.
Oh.
But who's counting? Hit it, Noah.
Oh, almost hit that 3 right there. It's right back to Potigel.
Come on,
right,
Noah.
Oh. Come on. Ooh. Come on, Noah.
Wide open. There it is. Oh. Colton Smith. And his own rebound, and he's fouled.
We know Noah and John sometimes broadcast here on IGN. Right,
yeah, they do some of the girls' games.
Yeah.
And John trying to give Noah a couple assists. Maybe John just wants to pad his stats and get more assists, but Noah's had a few open tonight. But, you know, you look at his shoulders, and, you know, he's a rebounder. He wants those stick backs.
Shep Ward.
He wants the ball.
Shep coming in there for John Potigel, the tremendous Brave senior. That might be his last action for this evening, but he will be back, and if the Braves are going to have something to say to Wyoming, John will have to be involved with that. C.J. Hayden with a stick back. C.J. now up to 12 points on the evening.
Can't wait for that exciting Wyoming game. That student section's going to be packed.
Well, hopefully the rest of the stands will be, too. Eli Riggs waiting to come in, I believe, for C.J. Hayden at the next stoppage of play. Sykam, he's hit 2 threes already tonight. Dykes. Bryant, and he steps out.
In comes in Eli Riggs and
wait a minute, no. Well, they're going to call CJ on a push.
Well, coming in for CJ, Eli, and for Zachary Jones, Junior Cam Miller making his first appearance of the night.
CJ exits the game with 12 points. Yeah, I mentioned Cam Miller, number 11, the only junior on the roster. And he'll be guarding number 11, Jack Parlament for Parlament. Alex Dykes with his 5th and 6th points of the evening.
Miller trying to get open.
Colton, and it's wide open.
Frazier.
Noah Frazier, no.
Oh.
Shoot. And Eli Riggs commits a foul. And it's so the Braves can bring in a couple new players.
Come on, Eli, that's absolutely unacceptable right there.
Now Noah Frazier coming out of the game. Colton Smith coming out of the game.
Freshman Ethan Cole making his first appearance of the night.
Ethan, you know, down in the rotation for the Braves, but obviously next year he's going to be a critical piece of what the Braves do. A tremendous athlete. Bryant misses. Eli Riggs with the rebound. Shep Ward.
They got numbers.
Charlie Escherding will not shoot. Cam Miller. Ethan Cole.
Three. Oh, got it.
Freshman Ethan Cole.
Three-pointer Ethan Cole.
Nothing but net for Ethan Cole. It comes in William Bennett and Jim Leibel at the score table. And it's
out of bounds. So Ethan Cole, you know, was did a great job on the football field this year. Actually filled in as quarterback when Pottigel was hurt. And also an outstanding lacrosse player for the Braves. Again, just a freshman. He hasn't had a chance to play yet. And seen on the back. There's Eli Riggs coming out of the game. And Shep Ward. Exiting. So only one senior left to take out, and that's Mr. Ishverding.
Cam Miller will bring up the ball for the Braves. Show him what he can do. Oh, never mind.
William Bennett out to Charlie Ishverding. William Bennett. First three of the season.
Wow, really?
Yep.
Oh, my God.
There's a rebound for William. He's got the mojo. Give him the ball. He's open. No. Jim Lever. Oh.
Two inch fouls. Foul.
Jim Lever, the big sophomore for the Braves, also an outstanding baseball player, a pitcher for the Braves that'll be starting practice here in a couple weeks. Braves baseball team last year went 14-0 in the CHL, first time in league history that a team went undefeated. Not an Indian Hill team, but any team in CHL history went undefeated in baseball. Here goes Charlie Ishverding and William Bennett. Dev Masali and Jalen Williams, two seniors do come in. Jim Lebel misses the shot. The buck 40 left. There goes a three. It's off. Ethan Cole dives for the Cam Miller gets it.
Trying to get it out of the jump ball, and he does! Ready to get
it up. Jalen
Williams.
Williams
a three! Oh!
Oh, almost a steal there. Jalen Williams. Bryant with a miss. Ethan Cole. Oh, great hustle, Ethan. Minute left here, and we still have two seniors on the floor. Oh, Ethan Cole, Cam Miller, looking for an outlet. Somebody get open. Masali was open. Masali. Here's Masali.
Shoot that! Oh!
28 seconds left, and here comes Cam Miller, and he commits a foul. It's only the third team foul, but Cam Miller, so they can bring in James McGrath and Ashton Graham, and the two seniors. Masali and Williams go out to hugs from their coaches.
In comes in Ashton Graham and James McGrath, right, first time in the game.
Two sophomores that will be important juniors on next year's team.
Cam Miller playing lockdown defense here. Everyone is right now.
Four seconds, three, two, and Finneytown will not take a shot. And final score, the Braves win 53-28. More importantly, on senior night, every senior got ample playing time, and everybody had an opportunity to score. And Noah Frazier with our unofficial count of 5 rebounds, a career high.
Way to go, Noah.
Yeah. I think on offense, maybe they should start posting him down low. But the Braves emerge victorious, and the Braves are now go to 9-2 in league play, and that big game on Friday with Wyoming looming ever present for Indian Hill, and hopefully Coach Ricardo Hill has saved some of this mojo for Friday night, because they're going to need it.
Yes, they will.
Again, great contributions from all the boys, and Coach Hill will be joining us here in a minute or two. He just wants to say something to his team. He just motioned to us that he'll be up in a minute. He just wanted to congratulate the kids on a W. Again, the Braves go to 12-7 overall, and 9-2 in the league. And nice balanced scoring tonight, Patrick. The Braves shared the ball very, very well.
But most definitely, I can agree with that one. I think for at least this season, this may be my last broadcast of the winter sports season. So, Tony, it's been an absolute honor.
Patrick, I've enjoyed it. And, you got another year of eligibility.
Oh, yeah, right? I do.
So, hopefully we'll be together football, basketball, and maybe baseball a year from now. But the Braves did a terrific job today, spreading things out, getting Deb Misal and Jalen Williams got several opportunities to score, and that was part of the game plan as well. So every senior, I think, had some shots, except I believe Charlie Isherding, who. We know he's a magnificent athlete, and he can score if he wants to, but he passes up open opportunities. I know he does it on the soccer field. If he sees a goal.
Oh, yeah, he takes it.
But basketball, he prefers to be more of a facilitator.
You know what? That's always great to see from somebody, Definitely fun if those people who aren't playing as much start to play.
Yeah. But we're waiting here for Coach Hill for some post-game comments. Zach Jones does leave the Braves in scoring this year. I want to mention something about Eli Riggs. Coming into tonight's game, Eli Riggs had 152 points on the season, second on the team. Eli Riggs only taken 95 shots.
Oh, my God.
He's averaging almost 1.6 points per shot, which is unheard of, and especially for a guy who doesn't shoot threes.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. No, just amazing. So Coach Hill is approaching the booth, and anyway, Coach, congratulations. Congratulations, Coach, on number 209. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
But who's counting?
Right. That's hilarious. Anyway,
you played a couple of your seniors tonight, huh?
Yeah. It was a joyful game, and we wanted to make sure that we recognize those guys tonight, and then we can get totally focused for Friday night.
There's a game Friday night?
A small one.
Yeah. I know you're going to be ready for that one in the next couple days. Actually, probably as soon as you leave the broadcast booth, you're going to be prepping for that, right?
Yeah, we'll be ready.
And all your seniors had plenty of opportunities to score tonight, and that was great. They shared the ball, and they were looking for the seniors. Why doesn't Charlie Isherding shoot?
You know what? Charlie is the ultimate team player, so he's not going to force anything. And he's a guy that just want to do what's best for the team and win. That's why he's so successful in soccer. But those guys, we were definitely unselfish tonight. And those seniors, we started the group with John, Noah, Shep, CJ, and Eli. Those kids are 13-year guys in the district, and they've played basketball since first grade.
Wow.
So that's why they all started tonight. And Charlie was in that group, but he took a couple years off from basketball. But those five guys, I thought that, you know, we were trying to do them some justice by letting them have senior night together.
And what happened to John in the first quarter? It looked like he hurt his hand or his wrist.
Yeah, he just jammed his thumb.
Okay.
So it was cool.
Because I noticed he's walking over there at with Brian Phelps, athletic director Brian Phelps, and Dennis Walker, our public address announcer, and doesn't have the wrap on anymore. So.
Nah, he's cool. He jammed his thumb, but, you know, he's a tough guy. He didn't want to come out the game, so he's cool.
That's great. And you got C.J. Hayden seems to have a little hop in his step and played very well tonight.
Yeah.
Colton Smith played well. And
yes. I thought
everybody's focused and ready to go for Friday.
Right. I think it's going to be a fun environment, fun game for us. I think the kids, I think they're ready to compete. And that's, you know, that's the fun part about being a high school coach, right? That you can see these guys develop and continue to prosper, and that's what it's all about.
Would you encourage part of Braves Nation and everybody to come out and support them on Friday night?
Oh, absolutely. It's going to be the hottest ticket in town.
It's a big game, Indian Hill, Wyoming, 7:30 right here at Indian Hill Gymnasium. And Coach will be leading the charges with his 11 seniors. I've never heard of 11 seniors on one team.
You know what? Me either.
And you've coached a couple years, haven't you?
Yeah, a few.
Yeah.
But this is, you know what? It's a special group, though. Those guys have been in the district a long time.
The final game stats up on the monitor. Coach, anything you want to say about
it? No, I mean, what really sticks out that I love, I mean, obviously, we should be a good rebounding team, but I love that we had 17 assists out of our 53 points. That's huge.
Yeah, that's great. You had 8 turnovers in the first quarter. You turned them over 8 times in the first quarter when you had the press on. And you took the press off the last 3 quarters and only had 7 for the rest of the game. That's
I thought, you know, those guys are good guys over there. And I saw that they were overmatched. So I thought that we can work on some other things. And that's what we did.
But good. Well, you did it well. It was a nice win. I'm glad John Pottegel's healthy, because we need every healthy body for Friday night.
Absolutely.
And it looks like your big man rotation, everybody did, you know, all contributed, all did well, and everybody hopefully focused and ready to go.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep.
And you and the coaching staff, too.
We're good. Tonight, we have a reception right now for our seniors. So we're going to go up here celebrate the seniors tonight, and then we'll start preparing.
Great. Well, Coach, thanks again for joining us. Thanks for Bravesland for joining us again. Our director, Denny Dupps, Steve Overberg, Gino Cardosi, and as always, the cast of thousands. I'm Tony Harris for Coach Ricardo Hill and Patrick Langworthy. Good night and good basketball.
Thank you.
Exclusive coverage of tonight's game on the Indian Hill Television Network has been a copyrighted presentation of the Indian Hill High School Video Department.